Hey Seacoast, Pastor Adam here. Hope everybody is doing well. Today we're going to continue looking into the Psalms, and we're going to look specifically at Psalm 46. Today I want to look at a verse that many of you will already be familiar with. It's verse 10 from Psalm 46. It says, "Be still and know that I am God." You've probably read it before or seen it on a refrigerator magnet, and what I love about this psalm is the meaning behind the words. In this verse, that first phrase, "be still," means literally to cease striving. And I don't know about you, but that's just good advice for me because I always seem to be pushing towards something. There's always another goal or another challenge, and it's important for me to remember that at times God is just whispering, "Hey, slow down. Cease striving." But what really blows me away in this verse is the word the writer uses next. The word "know" in Hebrew is the word yada. And it does mean to know, but it also means so much more than we might think, because it's the same word that we see in Genesis 4, where Adam and Eve were first intimate with each other. It says that Adam knew Eve and she became pregnant. So now that all the guys are listening to me and I have your attention, let me tell you why that's important. The word "know" in Hebrew carries implications of intimacy and trust. God wants us to slow down and intimately trust that He is still God. When everything around us might be falling apart, this is good advice for us. It's just good advice for us right now, and everything is falling apart. You know, Pastor Chip recently shared a story with me about an exercise craze back in the 80s. It wasn't CrossFit or Pilates, it was aerobics. You remember that, like with the leg warmers and the headbands and all the things? And as people started to do it, they had this next logical question, which was, how hard do I have to push myself in order to benefit from this? The answer was might not be what you think. The experts said, you've got to push yourself hard enough to elevate your heart rate, but easy enough to maintain a conversation. And it's amazing to me how that still applies to us today. Maybe now more than ever, in fact. Recently, all of us have had our normal routines be interrupted, haven't we? But that interruption might also provide us with an opportunity. It's an opportunity to reconsider our pace, an opportunity to reset our cadence, to ensure that we continue in an intimate conversation with God every day. Let me pray for you that that would be what you experience in this time. Father, we do thank you that while we're facing some uncertain circumstances, that you are still God and we can be still and know that and trust in it. And I pray that in what has been interrupted for us, you would help us to reset our pace in a way that we could maintain a kind of intimacy with you that maybe wasn't there before. And we pray in Jesus' name, amen.